Well, Keith, this is like baptism by fire. I thought I'd been in some famous tunnels before, the Channel in Europe, the Lincoln and the Holland Tunnel in New York. Shoot, I've even taken my wife down the Tunnel of Love. But on the second week in October, this tunnel at the Cotton Bowl is the most intense place. Mark my words, this is unbelievable. Oklahoma just took the field. Texas is getting ready to go, and they are set to go. Let's let the Longhorns have the field.
My advice, Todd, is get out of the way because the Longhorns are coming. Keith Jackson, hello again, everybody. I'm happy I live long enough to come back for one more of these. Dan Fouts also here for the first time. Dan, there are a lot of storylines here. 10 times the winner of a national championship has come out of this ball game. Is Texas going to be another one?
Well, they could be because of the quarterback, Vince Young. He's the most dangerous and exciting quarterback in all of college football. We've seen him take our breath away with just incredible plays. But what I like, what I've seen so far this year, he's embraced the most cherished quality a quarterback can have. That is being the unquestioned leader of this Longhorn football team. In critical times like last week against Missouri on a third down and 30, he made tacklers look like a picket fence as he raced to the first down. And earlier this year when the game was on the line, he led Texas to a come-from-behind win over Ohio State. And Keith, nobody will ever forget what Vince Young did against Michigan in the Rose Bowl.
Right, he turned into Walter Mitty. The big hammer for Oklahoma, Adrian Peterson, their running back, sore ankle.
Well, he's not going to be 100%. In fact, in pregame warmups, I thought he looked absolutely terrible. Heavily taped, pads not on. In fact, he did not run one play with the first team offense. But Oklahoma's okay without Peterson because of the way Rhett Bomar operates out of the shotgun. He ran it in high school. He has a good feel for the zone read game, and he's taking better care of the ball. No turnovers last week against K-State, and turnovers will just kill you in this great game.
The Texas Longhorns have just taken a timeout to talk about their circumstance. They were stalled for a moment until that sweep put them in business at the 13, and the loss of 2 yards as Young went shopping for a receiver and didn't find one. And now it is second down and 12 for the Longhorns. The ball is marked just outside the 15. Young is out of the shotgun. Puts it high in the air, into the corner of the end zone. Touchdown! Romont Taylor plays jump ball in the end zone with DJ Wolf.
Man-to-man coverage on the outside against DJ Wolf. Watch Romont Taylor separate with speed and then with elevation, and a perfect throw from Vince Young as he goes 5 for 5 on that drive, 65 yards and that touchdown. What a start for Vince Young.
And David Pino is in out of Matt Nordgren's hold, and Nick Schroeder snapping the ball. They try the point. It's up and it's good.
Time for our Nissan Drive summary. 12 plays, 82 yards, 5, almost 6 minutes off the clock. Key block here by redshirt freshman tight end Peter Ullman. Named 86 right there. That gives Charles the sidelines. That was a 4th-and-1 that the Longhorns converted.
That was the play that kept it moving down the road for them. For a 7-0 lead, and now Texas will kick off. Greg Johnson will handle the kickoff. Left puts it down the field. It's coming down at the 6-yard line to Reggie Smith. Reggie Smith, who is a freshman safety, returning the kick to the 22-yard line. Rhett Bomar, quarterback for the Oklahoma Sooners, comes out of Grand Prairie, Texas. Redshirt freshman, big guy, 6'2", 215. He has an appetite for running the ball. Numbers are not imposing yet. Only thrown 6 to 9 passes. Last 2 games, he had no picks. And he does not scare easy, but he is in for an interesting afternoon. We'll see about Adrian Peterson. For one thing, he's not out there. He is not on the field. Kewan Jones will be your tailback. He is a senior, and he can do a lot of things for you. And Paul Thompson, who had moved from a quarterback to a wide receiver, is out there right now as Bomar stands up and throws it hard and misses his target, James Moses. The Gillette M3 Power starting lineups, backs and receivers, and told you Adrian Peterson is not on the field right now. He has a sprained ankle. That means that Kiwan Jones will be busy, and it could mean that the quarterback becomes more of a tailback. The offensive line for Oklahoma have had to move some people around there. Chris Bush is at center starting this ball game today with Chester Hurt. From this direction, going the other way with Fomar, the quarterback carrying, and he paid a high price for his ticket as Huff leads the tackles to stomp him. A lot of talent on this Texas defense. Roderick Wright's a ton in the middle. You got sophomore Frank Okam, Crowder and Robinson, relentless from the outside. A Sooner is shaken, a Texan is shaken up. Aaron Harris leads the linebackers. He is another one of those All-American type guys. I'm telling you, he had 10 tackles in the win over Ohio State. He had 18 tackles in this game last year. Killebrew gets a start today. In the secondary, Michael Huff is a football player. Just say, Sikkim, open the door, and there he goes. And right now, there's time taken for Crowder, who had been shaken up. Tim Crowder is a junior tackle out of Tyler, Texas, and he's coming off the field.
Had a big game against the Buckeyes in Columbus earlier this year when he picked up a couple of sacks. He is the rush defensive end, along with Robinson on the other side. Very important to this Longhorn defense.
Brian Arakpo goes in to replace him. It is third down now and six for Oklahoma. As they try to get something going, they empty the backfield. They've got four wideouts. Bomar's pass is thrown low, hard, and incomplete. And so Juwan Rankins, for whom the pass was intended, had no chance to get that one because it was thrown right into the ground.
And if it had been thrown properly, it wouldn't have picked up the first down either because Rankins ran his route too short. But Bomar off to a rough start. Two passes, both thrown in the ground.
Cody Freeby is in for the punting. Oklahoma, he's a left footer. Aaron Ross is the man returning. Standing back inside the 35 for Texas. Snap is good. There's no pressure on Freeby. Beautiful kick. High hanging spiral. Fair catch call inside the 35, 25. And they'll put it down at about the 23-yard line. So, whatever he's doing, it ain't hurting him, I'll tell you that. Because he took him right down the field for a touchdown in the opening possession. A little hand fake, a little fumble the football, knocked out of his hand. Vince Young comes back to cover it, but he was looking around, and Calvin Thibodeau came in and slapped it out of his hand.
Yeah, Thibodeau is number 58, coming from the blind side after the fake to Charles. Watch Thibodeau come right into the picture about now. Here he comes. Watch the right hand. Swipes the ball. But again, Texas finds a way of getting on the loose ball and preventing the turnover. They fumbled on the opening kickoff. Terrell Brown recovered that. Young fumbles here, but gets down on the ball.
It'll be second down and 13 for the Texas Longhorns now. Vince tends to wave that ball around like that, and he loses it quite a bit. This is Jamal Charles. He's a 190-pounder, and he gets up near the original line of scrimmage. He's got about 4 yards on the play. Texas is leading in the ball game by a score of 7-0. There's 6 minutes and 58 seconds to play in the first quarter of Cotton Bowl in Dallas. It is third down and 9 now for Texas in their second possession of the ball game. They forced Oklahoma to punt in their first possession. 3 and out. And the punt was a beauty by Cody Freeby. Now third and long and a whistle. Bevo's been a little jumpy at the outset because the Texas band down there, when they first cranked up today, he jumped about 3 feet off the ground, but he's since calmed down, and here's Vince Young on third down and 9, throwing down the sideline. The pass is incomplete. Lima Swede got his hands on it, couldn't hold it. Reggie Smith was there defending.
Again, it's going to be a blitz by Oklahoma. They're going to have man-to-man coverage on the outside. Lima Swede is 6'5". Working against DJ Wolf, That's a good play by Wolf to push him before the ball is in the air, and he gets help from his true freshman strong safety, Reggie Smith, coming over with a big hit.
Here's Texas' first punt of the ball game. Richmond McGee, a senior from Garland, will kick it. Jawan Rankins is waiting for it back at the 35-yard line of Oklahoma. Off a low snap, didn't get all of it. It's a tail dragger, though, and should take a Texas roll, and it does, and there's a penalty flag thrown back inside the 20-yard line. So let's see about the flag.
And we also have flag down off the play.
Yeah, they were trying to come up the middle, put pressure on the snapper, Nick Schroeder. And it's going to be holding against the Longhorns, and that's a big break again for OU as they'll get great field position.
So now the punter stands at his goal line. McGee will hit the ball around the 3 or 4 yard line, probably close to the 4. There's no pressure on him. He gets it out of there. And it's a better kick than the other one, but it can be returned at least a little bit as Rankins makes the catch, comes back about 4 yards, and it's going to be Oklahoma possessing the football at the Texas 48-yard line.
Well, here's the plan for today. They're going to run from the gun because Bomar is more effective out of the shotgun. And forever young on defense, the Sooners know that the Longhorn offense runs through Vince Young. They got to outrush the Sooners for Texas. They've never lost a game when they've outrushed an opponent. They're 63-0 under Mac Brown. And then on defense, get to the young quarterback early. They want to set the tempo and send a message. And this is great field position for the Sooners' second possession.
Right on the 48 hash mark. Bomar looking around, talking to his people. He's changing a play. The tailback comes up and says, "You want to tell me too, in case I got to carry it?" The tailback is Kewan Jones, and he gets the ball. Got a little bit of a block on the corner, and with his speed is able to get it down to the 42. Cedric Griffin on the tackle.
And the real benefit that the Sooners have is it, Kewan Jones. He's a senior, he's played in this game, gained over 2,000 yards rushing in his Sooner career. And he did the smart thing there, went up to the quarterback and got the right play, didn't he?
It'll be second down and 4 for the Sooners. Brett Bomar, another Texan going north. That's not uncommon. Just like a tailback, now he pitches, and he's got the first down. That'll go down to the 37, and the Sooners pick up their first down of the ball game.
Just a triple option type of offense. They run out of the shotgun formation. Good decision on the pitch by Bomar as he came down the line of scrimmage to the right side here. Good block there by James Moses. That sealed the corner.
And first down at the 37. Bomar throwing. Throws the ball very hard, and the ball goes right through the arms of Paul Thompson, who was his backup quarterback and still is the backup quarterback. Going hard.
He's got those freshman jitters.
Yeah. How would you like to have that kind of adrenaline again?
Wow.
Here comes this corner. It's Jacob Gutierrez, and Jacob takes a pretty good lick as he comes around the corner and gets inside the 35-yard line. Cedric Griffin hit him.
And middle linebacker Aaron Harris, number one tackler for the Longhorns, coming in out of that middle linebacker spot. He gets him low, and then the horns clean up. But you can see how important Roderick Wright and Frank Okam are. They will try to keep Harris clean so he can run sideline to sideline to make tackles.
Right now, Bomar needs to put some touch on a forward pass. It is third down and 6. Flag is thrown right at the 35. Killebrew was the man who came over, a linebacker, outside backer, and held up Bomar and made the tackle. Steve Juszczyk, the referee, against Oklahoma. So Texas surely will refuse the penalty and force the Sooners into a fourth and long.
Holding. Offense. Number. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
Freebie will come out because this is just too long a field goal try for Hartley. His career long is only 40 yards, so the punt team will be called upon here. Actually, Hartley is out there. He's going to be able to... Stoops going to give him a shot at a 52-yarder.
That's pretty big.
That is huge.
Maybe he won't do it.
Yeah, the Sooners have always been good at executing fake field goals, but Texas is on to them a little bit. They're not going to go for any fake here.
Cody Freebie is the punter, and he's the holder. Garrett Hartley. Hartley's kick is on the way. It's a low line drive sort of a thing. Good. It wasn't pretty, but it went over 52 yards. When you go distance like that, you have to hit it low and hard, and he did, and got away with it. Career best.
Well, he had a lot of trust in his place kicker to go from 52 yards, and that is a very long kick, and it's always going to come out low, and if you clear one like that.
And because they changed the rule about leaping in the middle of the pile there, it's really a benefit to field goal kickers. They don't have to worry about kicking it low because nobody's going to risk that penalty coming down on their own men if they leap up in the air.
So Hartley now, who's had that moment of triumph, will kick it off. Good. Way back beyond the field of play. It'll come to the 20. First down.
Well, here's a look at the Dr. Pepper Big 12 update. Big game this afternoon, Nebraska. In the Big 12 North at home. They'll be going up against Texas Tech.
Both these teams being in that Southern Division just redoubles the value of this, of a win in this game.
No question about it. This is almost like the Big 12 championship game.
Sheldon Young is in at the tailback position now for Texas. Sharing the time with Jamal Charles at that position. Young was the ball rolls out of the pile up and Oklahoma's on it. Fumbled in the pile and the ball came out and Zach Latimer jumped all over it. And the Sooners get another break. DJ Wolf looked like the man that batted it out.
I think he did, Keith, and he came from the outside here. Selvin Jones with his first carry of the day. Here comes Wolf, 25, and he pops that ball loose with his right hand. Texas has fumbled three times here in the first quarter. They don't get this one back. The Sooners have great field position. Again, turnovers playing a major factor in this great series.
Well, if you keep giving it away, the other guys will beat you. And Adrian Peterson comes into the ball game for the first time. Sore ankle and all. He is a single back. First down at the Longhorn 26-yard line. He does not know the play. Now Bomar has changed it, given it to him. Better hurry up. They just get it away. Go to Peterson. And Adrian Peterson on that sore leg goes inside the 20 and down to the 19 before Cedric Griffin can bring him down.
He's got a bad right ankle. You can see all the tape around that right ankle. So it's smart for the Sooners to run him on plays to the left. In case he has to make a sharp cut, he can cut off his good ankle. But he does not look good. But just the psychological lift he gave his team on first down there may be enough to get the Sooners in the end zone.
Kevon Jones comes back as Peterson limped off. He gained 7 yards on the carry. And now Beaumart goes back deep and hands it away to Jones. And Jones almost found his way between defenders. He got enough for a first down at the 15-yard line.
All right,
John, thank you very much. Here are the Sooners on the attack. Kiwan Jones, he stopped right at the line of scrimmage. The ball is on the Texas 15. It'll be second down and 10. 7-3 ball game with Texas leading.
You got to be wondering when Stoops is going to let Bomar throw a pass. He's 0-for-3 so far, has not been close. And with this type of field position down in the red zone, you can see just 60% for the Sooners.
Adrian Peterson has come back. Omar's calling the play at the line of scrimmage. Peterson is still limping, but he's in there, and Bomar wants to throw. He does. The pass is completed to Paul Thompson. Thompson has rolled back up the field, but there's going to be a gain to about the 9-yard line on the play. So that'll be a 6-yard pickup and bring up third down.
And that'll make Bomar feel a lot better, because that was a good throw. A quick hitch like that to the outside in this area of the field can be turned into a touchdown going the other way if it's off target. That ball was right between Thompson's 1 and 2 on his 12 jersey.
So Jones comes back at tailback now. Looking at a third down and 4. Ball at the Texas 9. Bidding for the lead in the ball game to the end zone. The pass is incomplete. It was intended for Rankins, defended by Cedric Griffin. And it was not a friendly greeting either.
No, it was perfect timing by Cedric Griffin. Ball thrown well by Bomar, thrown in the only area where it could have been completed. But the veteran senior Griffin with a good play.
Now Hartley will come back on fourth down. He kicked a 52-yarder a moment ago for Oklahoma's first points in the game. This is much milder. It's marked just inside the 17. It'll be a 26-yard field goal officially because it is just inside the 17. The kick is up, and it's good. So Texas continues to lead, but now by just one, as the Sooners get their second field goal, and it's 7-6.
Good defensive stand for the Longhorns because of plays such as this one by Cedric Griffin. He's reading the quarterback, breaks on the ball, may have got away with the right hand on that shoulder, but you're not going to get that penalty flag at this end of the field, I don't think. This is the Longhorns end of the field. You see the Sooners on the other end. Our quarterback comparison, Bomar with that one completion on the last drive to Thompson, and Vince Young almost perfect for the Longhorns, but he did fumble once. And the last time the Longhorns had the ball, they fumbled it right back to Oklahoma.
You need to put a handle on that thing because the way they're throwing it around, get themselves in trouble in the ball game that they figured to win. Hartley's been busy, hasn't he? Got all 6 of the Oklahoma points.
Kicked off a couple of times.
And he's talk about adrenaline. Kicker's adrenaline going through this young man's body.
He's only a sophomore out of Southlake, Texas. And here he goes. Romance Taylor and Terrell Brown. There'll be no return of this one. It's kicked to the back of the end zone. It'll be Texas ball, first down at its own 20. Update Adrian Peterson's condition now with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, unfortunately for the Sooner faithful, Adrian Peterson's found himself back on the bench again. They've retaped it, and that's hard to believe because before the game, he had more tape on there. You stretch that thing out all the way back to Norman. During defense's time on the field, Adrian came behind the bench because there's no room for him at the bench to run. He was running straight sprints, no cuts. He's unable to cut on that right foot. The problem is he's from Texas, but he's right behind the Texas fans, and they have given him the business. Keith.
All done. Jamal Charles is in the backfield with Young. Charles gets the ball, cuts back into the middle, and finds some daylight. He is a speedster, and he is gone, gone. No flag. 80 yards. Three people had their hands on him, and he went 80.
Texas fans and coaches knew he was fast. He was a high school record. record holder in the hurdles. But he's got great lateral quickness and then breakaway speed, as we just saw.
There are two ways to talk about guys who play football and run track. Some are track men who play football, but this guy is a football player who runs track.
He just broke the tape, too.
He sure did.
The extra point try is up and good. David Pino taking over the full-time kicking business. Charles being attended to on the sidelines, and he just shoots.
It's just a draw play. Big hole up the middle. Great job up front by Casey Stoddard, breaking a tackle. Forget it right about here, huh?
Yep. Over. Spotlight game presented by ADT. That's beating Oklahoma 14-6. We've got 6:54 to play in the first half. And the threat of rain has gone away for the moment. Bright sun and expected to be that way for the rest of the weekend. Vince Young goes up under center for this one. He's got Jamal Charles behind him. Yes, Charles has not carried the ball since the 80-yard run for the touchdown. He still hasn't. Young dropping back. Hit by Clint Ingram.
Ingram's number 44 here. This is a long developing pass play after the play fake. So that you got to figure that the coverage in the secondary is excellent. And look at the speed as Ingram closes, gets off the block to pick up his second sack of the season. On first down, you couldn't ask for a better play with such field position against you as Ingram provided on that sack.
And it's second down and 19. Lost 9 yards on that sack. Third quarterback sack of this game by the Sooners. They do like to come after you. This time he goes straight back, gets it away, intercepted. It's Zach Latimer. The linebackers are having a big day for the Sooners, and there's a penalty flag thrown back inside the 45-yard line on the Sooner side of the field.
And it might be pass interference against the Sooners. Not against where the ball was intercepted, but down the field as Young was trying to squeeze it in.
Interception is gone. It is pass interference against Oklahoma.
Trying to get the slant route into the wide receiver on the top of the screen. The interception is going to happen right here, but there's the push. Boy, I tell you what, that is a very questionable call.
Pass interference on the defense. 15-yard penalty from previous spot. Automatic first down.
Take a look at the push here. Eric Bassey, number 13, and I don't see the contact at all. Bassey goes down. The receiver never hit the ground. That's Brian Carter. Stoops is obviously unhappy with that horrible call.
It might have happened earlier than that.
Yeah, but when they call pass interference, usually it's when the ball's in the air. If they would have called holding, then you might have an argument there.
Holding, I would have said holding, not pass interference. But whatever is done is done. It's first down for Texas. The ball is at the 46-yard line, thrown to the sidelines, incomplete. Lamont Taylor, he again had put air under the ball, thinking that Taylor could go out with a jump ball, but he wasn't anywhere near him.
14-6 at the Cotton Bowl. Talk about good genes for the Big Uglies, Keith. I know you like these guys. Jonathan Scott, Casey Stettard, Lyle Sendling, all Texas linemen. And look at this. Their fathers all played in the NFL. Of course, Ray with the Jets, Dave with the Detroit, Denver Broncos, and Lyle, his dad, Robin, played in the NFL for 8 years. So as you would say, that's some pretty good fertilizer for your youngsters. Keith.
I would indeed.
Only you would say that's good fertilizer. You're rubbing off on Todd, Keith.
No, I didn't say a word. I just listened.
Well, how costly was that penalty against OU? That's the first penalty that has been assessed against them this afternoon, and it took away a turnover.
But you know, when Oklahoma plays man-to-man, they are stopping the wide receivers of Texas. The only time they get in trouble is when they go play zone. When they play man-to-man and bring pressure on Young, they're doing quite well.
Vince Young, Selvin Young, and Romance Taylor are the people in the Texas backfield, if you will. Young keeps it, goes bouncing to the outside, and they got him to the hind leg, and that's a very good way to get hurt, because they had him out there for a little bit like a wishbone. Rufus Alexander was the man that had a hold of him, wouldn't let him go, and then help came.
Now you're really seeing the strength of this Sooner defense and their linebackers, Alexander, Latimer, and Ingram. Ironically, they combined to miss the tackle on Jamal Charles's 80-yard touchdown run, and don't you know that's in the back of their head when they get Vince Young by a leg. They're not going to let go.
Charles is back in the ball game. That's a good offensive line Texas has got on the field. I believe if they just hunker down and grind a little while, it might be to their advantage. So they haven't done it. Young had just called Texas last time out. He didn't like what he saw and immediately called for time. This game is always, not always, but oftentimes has been decided by mistakes. And again, that has been pretty much the theme here in the first half.
And really, that's what rivalries are all about, mistakes and controversies. I'm sure that pass interference call will go right in there with all the other questionable calls in this great series. But at that point, Oklahoma had momentum, both on offense and defense, and they were going to get great field position, which is more important than anything.
David Thomas had the run back onto the field. Looked to me like he brought the play in. So it is third down and 9 for Texas on the Oklahoma 45. Time for Young, passing underneath, the pass caught by Romance Taylor. He was a tailback a year ago, remember, and he hauls it on down the field for a first down.
Really a good call by Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, because once you get the ball in a former running back's hands who's now playing wide receiver, you're going to get something extra. And here's the extra that Taylor gives you. Taking care of contact, making sure he's got the ball, picking up a big first down.
That's a 22-yard pickup and a first down for Texas at the Oklahoma 23. In the traffic goes Jamal Charles, same kind of a move that freed him for 80 yards and a touchdown. He didn't this time. Sooners got him.
Turned up near the 20-yard line by number 99, C.J. Ayu.
100th game between these two teams. They moved into this building in 1930.
100th game, Keith, and 100 yards already for Jamal Charles.
Orange threatening again now, leading 14-6. We're coming down toward the end of the half. We've got 4 minutes now left to go in the first half. Passes away to the corner of the end zone, and it is incomplete. Too long, intended for Billy Pittman, and defending was Eric Bassey.
Young is lucky that he saw Bassey at the last second coming over into that zone, because Bassey had a beat on this ball. It was thrown high by Young. He threw it out of the back of the end zone when he saw number 13 running that way. Here's Bassey, number 13, trying to get the ball into the corner here. Bassey does a nice job of coming off his primary responsibility.
Third down and 8. My goodness. I guess he was throwing it for David Thomas, but he was covered in white.
Well, the key word there, Keith, is guess. I guess you're right. He was guessing that he was going to throw it to Thomas.
Lucky to get that thing back. This will bring David Pino into the ball game, the place kicker for the Longhorns, a 5'8", 180-pound senior out of Wichita Falls. He's 5 for 5 this year. David Pino, number 58, His career long was 42 yards against the Buckeyes at Ohio State. Game that the Longhorns pulled out very late. This will be a 37-yarder. A lot of leg on it. Good. So it's 17-6 now. He converts that 37-yarder. Texas leads. Horns up, 17-6. Sooners offense hampered considerably by the loss of Adrian Peterson, who's hampered by a severely sprained ankle. It's an inside sprain, too, and it's difficult.
And their passing game's been horrible. Just 3 of 12 for Bomar for 22 yards. Red Johnson hit it. Left puts it short and high. Taken by Reggie Smith. Can't be tiptoeing. You got to drop your shoulder and come on up the field.
Adrian Peterson is the deep back. Fake to him. He falls down. And this is Bomar running into three Longhorns. And if he keeps doing that, Paul Thompson's going to be playing quarterback.
Yeah, he could be calling the Undertaker to come get Bomar. He's a tough guy. Good size, very strong. You can see he's struggling in the passing game right now. Good to get him out on the run because he does throw well on the run. At that time, Texas was all over his receivers.
He got a couple of yards. It'll be second down, and they'll call it 7 officially. Peterson stays in. Pass is thrown. I don't know where it's thrown, but they get a flag on it. Penalty flag is thrown as the intended receiver ran between a couple of Longhorns. Malcolm Kelly was the receiver.
This ball was so far over the head. Yeah, Max saying it's uncatchable. There was no way Kareem Abdul-Jabbar couldn't have caught this one.
Pass interference on a defense. Number 5. 15-yard penalty from previous spot. Automatic first down.
They're going to call Brown for the pass interference. Let's take it out. Trying to get the ball to Malcolm Kelly, who's 6'4". Needed to be 8'4". You can't even see the ball in that picture. That's how far it was overthrown.
No way he could have caught it. But I guess the feeling was that he impeded his progress.
Still got to be catchable for that progress.
Bomar saw a little daylight on the left side and took off. Aaron Harris was there to stop him. Bomar sidearms it. Penalty flag again. Travis Wilson was down to get it, and they're going to mark it there as a catch. Be short of the first down, but let's see about the penalty.
Illegal formation on the offense. Not enough players. Up five. Second down.
Not enough players on the line of scrimmage. That's why you get that illegal formation call. Got to have 7 up there.
They'll need something in the clubhouse, in the Oklahoma clubhouse, to calm down dyspepsia after watching this first half. They've had some big opportunities, but have made mistakes that nullify. Now they go to 3 wideouts on the bottom of your picture, the one on top, and run the ball. This will be Gutierrez, and he's going to lose a couple of yards. And Aaron Harris is the man that stopped him. So now Oklahoma looks at 3rd and long with a passing game that has been utterly ineffective. There's Aaron Harris. Comes from Mesquite. And the bad news for all of you playing Texas in the future, he's a sophomore.
Third down.
senior, according to my book that graphic's wrong. Third down and 12. It's a low pass, incomplete pass. Joaquin Iglesias reaching down to get it. Aaron Harris is a senior. Absolutely.
Yeah, and Bomar's struggling in the passing game. Started the game throwing the ball low. We've seen him airmail a receiver. That one, he had a shot at Iglesias, but again, thrown low. And you've got a quarterback just shaking his head on the sidelines, wondering how he's going to get a completion.
Aaron Ross is standing back at the 20, and Cody Freebie now is in for his fifth punt of the first half. Didn't get a whole lot of that one. This could be returned. Yeah, that's good coverage by the Longhorns. And they stopped the return man up around the 30-yard line. And Todd, go ahead.
Well, Keith, Aaron Harris is a senior from Mesquite, Texas. No relation, but he is so he was honored this summer by his hometown of Mesquite with Aaron Harris Day for all he's done for the community and representing the city so well. And the guy is a true Renaissance man. He's prone to writing poetry in his off time where he's not sacking quarterbacks, Keith.
Didn't he promise us one for the game today?
If they win, I think we might get a good one.
First down on the 30 with 55 seconds remaining in the first half. Ducked it, picks it up, got it in. This is where he can kill you. Gets all the way to the 40 for a first down. Oyunda Getcha brought him down for Oklahoma. Oyunda Getcha.
You know, again, when I talked to Vince earlier this week, he was emphasizing how important it was for Texas to execute and execute their plays properly and execute. And I said, yeah, well, and then after you execute, you can ad lib. Pretty good at that.
Ball's on the 41, first down. Oyunda Getcha is another one of those players that's come out of the City College of San Francisco. Has the penalty flag, ball's in the air, pass thrown downfield is picked off by Oklahoma. That's going to be a dead ball, apparently. Dead ball foul. I want to go over to that City College of San Francisco and just breathe the air next week when we go up to do Cal game.
Hey, quite we a should program. Be a 40. Offense, number five. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Yeah, we need to get Billy Pittman for moving early. And the way that play turned out with the interception, that's a good penalty for Texas.
The interception doesn't stand because it was a dead ball foul. In other words, the foul occurred prior to the snap of the ball.
And the officials clearly blew their whistle and threw a flag at the same time, stopping the play.
32 seconds remaining to play in the first half. Texas has control of it right now.
Put some extra time on the clock because of that dead ball penalty.
Feeling around this area is that these two teams will cease to play their game here after they finish 2007 because there's a clause in the existing contract that allows them to go after 2007. And it's a divided camp pretty much, but there's some strong feelings that the city of Dallas hasn't really moved very quickly. And the renovation idea is not going to be in a low figure, and it's not going to take 6 months to do. It's going to take a couple of years. I don't know what'll happen. Feeling, I think, generally is that they'll go back to campus home and home.
You can see they added 9 seconds. The referee's microphone not working. He had to go over to the sidelines, get up on the phone. But it would be a shame, Keith, to move this out of this great setting. It's so unique.
It's a gym. It really is. It has been for so long. It's a great rivalry, and the schools feel good about coming here for it because the region has embraced both, and it's right in between the two campuses. So it'll be first down and 15 as we go now from 32 seconds, clock running. Vince Young, high, deep route downfield. He's got a man wide open. He's got the ball. Billy Pittman, touchdown. busted coverage. Pittman ran free.
That's just a killer play for Texas here at the end of the first half. Getting it all in one big bomb there to Billy Pittman. Vince Young with a great rainbow pass, just let the speedster run under it.
64 yards. And Pino for the point. The touchdown plays have been 15, 80, and now 64 yards. Kick is good. Be careful, don't crack a rib. 24-6 is the score now.
Young had time to throw as he rolls out. And watch how high he throws this ball. He's got Pittman in his sights right now, and he just lofts it down there right to the fingertips. In perfect stride for Pittman. Never had to slow down. Raises that one finger. Touchdown, Texas. You cannot say that Texas is being conservative today. This is Pittman's second touchdown catch of the year and his career long. And what a time for it to happen.
17 seconds remaining as the horns come out to kick off now. That was a dagger, boy.
Especially when you look at how poorly the Oklahoma offense has performed in the first half.
Greg Johnson, who comes from Lilburn, Georgia. Squirts it downfield. The Sooners don't handle it very well. Travis Wilson is going to get inside the 10-yard line. But Ohio State, boy, that's a pretty good football team. All right, they take a knee and go to the clubhouse. And if you look at the big plays, this has been the place today because Texas has certainly produced them, and they hold a 24-6 lead over the Oklahoma Sooners.
Nice training.
Lead for the Texas Longhorns, the number two team in the country, over the Oklahoma Sooners. And Dan, they've done it on big plays. A 15-yard jump ball in the corner of the end zone, 80-yard run, and a 64-yard pass run.
You know, if you take away that 80-yard run by Jamal Charles, Texas has not been able to run the ball. Vince Young has not been able to break free, but he's done it with his arm and with the big plays. And you got to give a lot of credit to Texas's defense. They have Rhett Bomar totally frustrated. His first half is one he'll want to forget.
And the Texas offensive line is strong enough, big enough, and tough enough just simply to protect Vince Young. He's been available, and they've got him a couple of times, but not in a harmful way.
You would think that Texas would want to pound the ball now against Oklahoma with this big lead. Yep. But they have been sloppy with the ball in that first half. You'd want to be sure that they have better ball security here in the second.
Well, Oklahoma now is going to get the ball first to start the second half of play. And I don't know. See if they can crank up something. That ball is kicked to the sidelines. It's taken at about the 17-yard line. There's a penalty flag on the field, and the return of the kickoff is to about the 25. Travis Wilson. Oh, there's been some laundry left laying on the landscape, and we'll see what that amounts to.
Offside. Kicking team. Number 18. Our penalty. Re-kick.
Well, they had the ball at the 25. They could have refused it and gone from there, but I guess they have the feeling that the idea was to get the ball up in the air and keep OU away from a big return by backing him up 5 yards. they can pick up five at the other end. That's not necessarily true.
Now, I'm wondering about this decision. I would like that ball at the 25-yard line if I'm a Sooner fan. Greg Johnson has a big leg. He can reach the end zone from here and pin the Sooners back deeper than that 25.
The intent on that one, obviously, was to get it up in the air and to give his people time to come down and nullify a return. Let's see what he does here. He might just go ahead and swing it full tilt. Let's see. Yeah. There you go. We're just going back to the 6-yard line for Travis Wilson. And down he goes. So he's taken down at the 19-yard line. Todd Harris talked to the Longhorn coach, Mac Brown, when they came out of the clubhouse. Here's that conversation.
Coach, great first half for you. Do you call off the dogs now, or do you go into attack mode a little more conservative?
Well, you're in a situation where OU is one of the winningest programs in college football. They're really well coached. They've got tremendous pride. This thing's not over, so we got to start back like it's 0-0 and keep playing.
Thanks for your time. Thanks, Todd.
All right, the Longhorn defense now, if they can pin Oklahoma, can give their offense the ball back in good field position. But let's see what the Sooners can do offensively after they've had their meeting in the clubhouse. Kewan Jones is the back standing alongside Rhett Bromar, and he's got the ball cutting back into the middle. We'll get from the 19 to the 21.
Time for our Pacific Life game summary. The first half stats. Texas is up 24-6 because their defense has held OU to only 2.1 yards a play. OU has four first downs, and they've been unable to sustain any drives because they've converted on only 1 out of 8 third downs.
The busiest guy on the Oklahoma side so far has been the punter.
And that's not good. No.
Movement along the front. That might be five right there.
Chris Messner came up out of his stance.
Chris Messner was a starter at the beginning of the season.
79. Offense. Still second down.
He's been moved. He's been dinged up some, and then he's been moved to help out injuries at other spots. And right now he's in there at right tackle because Brandon Braxton, his big freshman tackle, is a bit dinged up.
And remember, Oklahoma could have had the ball on the 25-yard line to start this second half. They've now back 9 yards from that point, all the way back to the 16.
And it's second down and 13. Lucky to get it back. It was intended for Thompson, and the only man that had a chance to catch it was Aaron Ross.
Well, you can see in that first half the problems that this Sooner offense has had. And there's your busy day for your punter, Cody Freebie, with 5 punts. But, you know, Bomar is trying to throw the ball to a quarterback in Paul Thompson. Thompson has 1 reception. And right now, this pass offense is in dire straits when your number one receiver is your backup quarterback.
Got another flag. This one's thrown from across the way. Dead ball foul.
Stop. Defense. 5-yard penalty.
That's 2 in a row. Ball goes back to the 11 now and becomes third down at 18. Well, the Sooners are going backwards to start the second half. Out of the end zone, throws it into the ground, and it is incomplete, and that will not be a grounding call because there was a man in the general area, and he was being hammered.
As Kewan Jones, number 20 there, and there's another shot for Bomar. Threw it right at the feet of Kewan Jones. No intentional grounding.
Ryan Orakpo, who's another freshman, he's playing tackle, or defensive end, that is, for Texas.
Did the Sooners have a worse start to a second half, down 18?
Yes, they could. Kick is out of there. The catch is made. And
he signaled a fair catch.
I thought his hand went up. Yeah, there's your flag.
There it is.
Aaron Ross is a cornerback who goes back on the punt. And he had raised the hand and dropped it and made the catch and was defending himself.
He can't run, though, after you put that hand up.
Nope.
You don't see the official carrying that flag in that top pocket very often, do you?
No.
Looks kind of nice.
Must have been a present. He wouldn't throw it off.
Well, the delay of game on the receiving team. Gave a fair catch signal, then ran with the ball. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Texas again to the attack now. The Oklahoma defense trying to hold up. They've been on the field a lot, though, and a lot of it has been in pass defense. There hasn't been, Texas hasn't run the ball that much except that one burst by Jamal Charles. This is Kewan Jones trying to, it's Charles again. And Charles trying to get outside, and Oklahoma now acutely aware of the sprinter speed that he brings to the ballpark.
Yeah, they're trying to string him out, use that sidelines as a 12th defender. And on his touchdown run, it was straight up the middle where he broke a couple of tackles. But they can string not only Charles out to the sidelines, but Vince Young, when he runs out to the sidelines, that's what they want to do.
Well, you possess the ball by running it successfully. Texas, Oklahoma last year, when Peterson went for 225 yards, they had the ball almost 37 minutes. That's a lot.
Huge third down for the OU defense.
Third and seven. Receiver waiting. I'm not sure that he was far enough to get the first down, though. David Thomas, the tight end. Mark by the linesman is close. Penalty flag back inside where the ball was thrown. That's going to be a roughing the passer call.
And you can see Vince obviously agreeing with this call.
From the end of the run, first down.
And this penalty, because it's from the end of the run, will give Texas great field position. There's the tight end open over the middle to Thomas, and out of the picture goes the quarterback, Vince Young.
Clint Ingram hit him.
Yeah, hit him good, too. That one hurt.
The penalty will put the football at the 29 of Oklahoma and first down, Texas. So quick.
That's the football player in the peak.
Yep.
We've seen his track speed straight ahead. But it's those quick feet. Stop like that, move laterally, then move down the field. Looks like he might have an ankle problem. You know, that big thing about that penalty, it looked to me like Thomas was going to be short of that first down.
Yeah, I think he was. This is what he's done there, and look at the people that he's moved ahead. Campbell, Williams, Benson. Are you kidding me? Ooh, that's, those fellows walk hallowed ground.
They walk on air.
This is Selvin Young getting some work now, the junior out of Houston. And he works his way through the traffic for about 3 or 4 yards. We're in third quarter of play, 6:22 to go. A slowed game now. At Oklahoma has been unable to chip away at the Texas 24-6 lead.
Yeah, they're setting their own tempo now, Keith. The clock is their enemy of Texas right now, or their ally, rather. They just want to make it keep running. And they're doing a good job of just that.
They used all of it that time, didn't they? Burned up the 25-second clock.
Delay game. Number 10, of the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Five wideouts. Texas. Loop to the corner, and it'll be touchdown, Billy Pittman.
Last time Texas won this ball game, Major Applewhite threw three touchdown passes. And Young has just thrown his third touchdown pass.
Pino for the point.
Good. Hey, you got to wonder about Travis Wilson, his health, and remember, Rhett Bomar limped off the field.
He's limping back on.
Yeah. And Wilson is out there with him as well.
Nobody in front of him, so he pulls it down and takes off. Goes into a head-first dive. That's dangerous. They mark him just short of the 40. They got to go inside the 38 to get their first down, so they're looking at 2.5 yards at least. Maybe close to three.
Taking a lot of time, too, getting things squared away at the line of scrimmage.
That won't work. That was Kewan Jones coming back to run the inside slant, and there was nothing there but burnt orange.
Now, Michael Griffin came out of his free safety spot and really finished off this play. Another tackle for Griffin. He's the second leading tackler. Watch him read this sweep play, basically. He just comes up, lays that shoulder in, and Jones goes down sideways.
And it's third down and short three. Oh, my goodness. He had his man.
He picked off.
He got intercepted. He threw the ball. It bounced off the shoulder pads of the receiver Johnson, and Michael Griffin dove in there and intercepted.
Looked like the ball came down on the receiver's chest, and Griffin was just there to rip it off. Little slant route here for Johnson. Bobbles it, bounces it. That's a good call. That ball was in the air, and talk about being right on the spot, and down on another spot goes the quarterback, Bomar, one more time.
He'll be sore, sore, sore.
He'll be sore in about 40 years from this game.
35-yard line. And it is Vince Young getting loose. Needs a block. Got people tracking him, and they finally take him down just as he crosses midfield and picks up another first down. Ooh, that's an upset of considerable dimension. This is Selvin Young, fresh legs, finding some running room. That ball is given to Young again, and Selvin getting in some work will pick up a first down for Texas as the horns now are working on running the ball out of this particular formation.
They're doing a good job of calling the right play at the right time. The Sooners had another corner blitz coming that time from Anya Nagecha, and that's exactly where Texas ran the ball, into that vacated area to pick up the first down.
39-yard line. 31-6, and we're inside a minute to go in the third quarter. Thank you. Sooners might have got away with offsides there because Ingram was blitzing from this side and he was a little bit ahead of things, but that's all right. He got away with it. Clock ticking along. We go inside a half minute to go in the third quarter. And the sky is blue and the sun is bright. And the temperature very pleasant now. And the folks, a couple hundred thousand of them probably, have come to the fair. Going into the evening. The crowd is 75,452 here at the ball game. Vince Young's pass. Incomplete. And that stops the clock with one tick remaining. They ran Lima Swede at D.J. Wolf.
This is such a unique situation in this stadium, Keith, with half burnt orange, the other half crimson. And one side is always cheering, and the other side is quiet. And so the players really can't get an indication of how well they're doing unless you look at the scoreboard. But body language has a lot to do with it, too. You look over there at the Sooners, and they look totally defeated right now. And look at the scoreboard, you know why.
Big plays do funny things to your psyche, don't they?
Well, you know, some of the biggest plays in that first half was Texas recovering their own fumbles. Right. Opening kickoff of the game, Terrell Brown got on his. Vince Young was hit from behind. He fumbled, but recovered it.
Third and eight. Goes to the first down and gets it as he completes the pass to his tight end, David Thomas.
Water damage can cost you thousands. An unexpected leak.
Here we go to the final quarter of the 100th game between the Oklahoma Sooners and Texas Longhorns. We're at the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. This is the scoring by quarter to this time. 14-6. 24-6, and now 31-6. Texas is in control of the ball game, and they have the ball, moving it again toward the Oklahoma goal line. Selvin Young has moved into the backfield, replacing Jamal Charles, who looked like he might have sprained an ankle and went to the clubhouse. And I think we've changed quarterbacks, too, for Texas. Colt McCoy, I think, is going to be the... No, Young is still there. Colt McCoy is warmed up, and I'm sure that Nordgren is also warmed.
I was getting warm, too.
Were you? But you get to a situation in the ball game where I think Mac Brown might consider Vince Young a bit.
Well, you always can have an injury. There's no question about that. And an injury to Vince Young at this part of the season with still some tough games coming up and with big dreams ahead of them, would be absolutely critical. I would think that after this drive, perhaps, that Vince would take a seat.
Yeah, if they put it in the end zone. That would run it up to a substantial margin, and it's obvious, too, that Texas is content to run the ball because by running the ball, they control the clock. And the longer they've got it, the less the other folks, less harm the other folks can do to them. Michigan and Minnesota, we heard about that a little while ago. Minnesota, North Carolina State beat Georgia Tech.
Number 11.
Here's another one of the false start calls we've had. I think that's the fifth one in the ball game. So both teams have not held their poise at times, even though the issue, frankly, seems no longer in doubt.
Yeah, it really hasn't been in doubt since that first quarter. Total dominance over exactly 300 yards more. Give credit to the Sooner offense and their defense. But with Adrian Peterson not able to play at 100%, the Sooners were doomed from the start.
Third down and eight for Texas. Pass goes down the middle, and it is caught. It's David Thomas, who's had a big ball game, tight end. We got a flag back here with a referee back upfield at about the 33-yard line. Rufus Alexander may have been involved in a little bit of nailing the quarterback.
We have setting dead ball clubhouse, number 73 of the defense. Number 42 of the off first down.
Got him.
Yeah, I got that a little bit confused, but it's Jonathan Scott, the left tackle, after the ball is thrown. Here they are wrestling on the ground here. It's 315 pounds going on top of Rufus Alexander there. And Rufus didn't like that. But it's after the play, so the completion will stand, and the Longhorns are at the 5-yard line.
First and goal. Young, Zeldon Young, touchdown. Zeldon Young pounds it in from 5 yards. He was the starter when the season began, and then he lost some playing time as Charles evolved. And now he's back in, and he probably will stay there the rest of the ball game because of the apparent injury, however slight it might be, to Charles.
Yeah, I like that play selection because you know Jonathan Scott had to be hot after getting that penalty on the previous play, so they ran right behind the big senior tackle, making his 36th start of his Longhorn career, and he cleared the way.
Point by Pino is good. And we are in the fourth quarter with 13 minutes and 6 seconds to play. Bounces it along the ground. Finally fielded by a Sooner back at the 12. Lindy Holmes. He gets to the outside. Got a little bit of help and got across the 30-yard line. And you got another penalty flag back at the 42-yard line. Oklahoma will be home. In fact, both these teams play at home next week. The Sooners will have Kansas, and Texas will have a pretty tough customer, Colorado. This is a good long visit.
Could be multiple fouls on this play.
One over there by the sidelines, and then one back here with the at the 42-yard line.
That's important that the officials take control of this game because it could get ugly.
We have three penalties.
Oh my.
On the kicking team. First one, offside, decline. Then we have personal foul, face mask, on kicking team. And then we also have dead ball, personal foul, on the kicking team. We'll go 30 yards from the end of the run. First down.
So now Oklahoma is camped on the Texas 37-yard line.
Boy, they got a best drive of the game going, don't they?
Yes, they do.
This is a state fair. They got 3 for 30 there. They got 3 penalties on one play, and they picked up 30 yards. Now they just moved the ball back a yard. So been that kind of day for Oklahoma. 30 steps forward and 1 step back.
Now they go. Omar's under center, calling his play. He's working and headed toward that Texas crowd down there in that end zone, and it's noisy, and he better hurry up because that 25-second clock's going to bite him. Passes away, and he's lucky to get it back. It almost picked by Terrell Brown. And a moment now with a sunburned Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, normally I would be sunburned, but I've got this new invention by the folks at Nike. It's called MaxSight. It used to be the saying, it must be the shoes. Well, now it must be the contacts. These are sports-tinted contacts. No prescription. I'm happy to say I've got perfect 20/20s, but I'll tell you what, they are the strangest things. It's like wearing sunglasses. You can look into the sun and have no squinting whatsoever. And 20 of the Longhorns are wearing them today, including tight end David Thomas.
Did they pay for that commercial?
Am I supposed to draw a swoosh on his forehead?
Pass is complete on a slant to Joe John Finley. And he'll pick up 7 yards on the play.
I wonder what happened to old Blue Eyes.
They're red.
First catch for Joe John Finley. It's going to be a big part of this pass offense today, but along with James Moses, the tight ends have been shut down by Texas.
Finley got a touchdown pass, his first one as a sophomore last week.
Yep.
Well, that's the same play with a different catcher. Juwan Rankin makes that catch, and you can move your chains well down the field to the Texas 15-yard line.
Yeah, here's that slant route, Keith, you're talking about. Bomar really steps into this throw, too. Gets it right, leading Rankins perfectly before the contact comes.
Snapped a little low. Now he's got to run for it. Runs outside that 5-yard parameter and throws it away. We told you the crowd today was 75,452. Last year they had a record crowd of better than 79,000 for this game. And as we've said, there's some question about how many more games between these two will be played on this field. Second and 10. He's done a lot of wandering around.
Well, he's getting signals from the sidelines, and then he's relaying those signals to the his teammates.
Texas defenders are just standing there looking at him. Ball is caught. Finley shakes off a defender and walks in for the touchdown for Oklahoma. Omar was hit by Robinson.
Hard. Yeah, and Darryl Brown went for the interception. And when you've got a body at 6'6", 240, like Joe John Finley, Brown's just going to fall right off him. Here's that shot. Man, that's going to hurt tomorrow. And the tomorrow after that. Watch this catch by Finley as Brown tries to step in front for the interception. He bounces off, and Finley scores.
And they'll go for two. Spread them out with five wideouts. Incomplete. They fail on the two-point conversion. Huff got a little piece of it and knocked it down. And once again, Bomar was buried under burnt orange.
We all know.
9:19 to play in the ball game. Oklahoma coming out now, possessing the ball in good field position at the 49-yard line of Texas. A couple of touchdowns will make it look pretty good in history. Bomar throws quickly. There's nobody over here on Kiwan Jones, and Jones tiptoes out of bounds down at the 36, inside the 36, call it the 35, and that'll be a first down. They had horns leaning inside, and he broke outside, and nobody there. And Bebo has just concluded his fourth nap. He's turned his back to the field.
Well, there's a lot of females here at the State Fair.
Bomar lets it go deep for the corner. And Malcolm Kelly can't track it down. Second down and 10 for the Sooners on the 36-35, actually, of Texas. Blitz coming, pass away, thrown into the ground. Might have been tipped by Michael Huff as he came boring in. Huff is a load at 6'1", 205, coming from that safety position, because he's in, I mean,
top speed by the time he arrives.
And he is the smartest defender on the team, according to Dwayne Aquina, the defensive coordinator. As he comes on the blitz, watch number 7 get up in the air and deflect that ball. In fact, Aquina says he's the smartest player he's coached since Chuck Cecil. They two were at the University of Arizona.
That's a coverage, almost a coverage sack, but he breaks out of it. There's the value of the strength of the freshman as he takes off up the middle of the field and picks up a first down at the 22-yard line of Texas. Omar trying to slant over the right side, and the initial contact was Brian Robinson, the slanting tackle, and the play was over right there. Here's Todd.
Well, Keith, I don't want to call him greedy, but last year he did win the Bronco Nagurski, the Butkus Award, and he was the first-round draft pick of the Kansas City Chiefs. Of course, I'm talking about Derek Johnson, but Derek, one thing you were never able to accomplish, and that's beat OU, but today looks like it's going to happen for your Longhorns.
Well, definitely. OU's a great team and a pretty good team this year, and the Longhorns came out and really prepare for this game, and you see right now they're really working hard, and they're going to beat them.
Good luck to the Chiefs.
Thank you.
Second down, 11. He's a pretty good one too, wasn't he?
Oh boy. Gonna be a great pro too.
Ball's loose. Texas got it. They threw the beanbag back there. Bomar's hurt, and it's a big old tackle, Roderick Wright. All 315 pounds, Brian Robinson hit him, and the Oklahoma quarterback is still down on his knees. Now he's upright, but it was a huge lick by Robinson, a long run by Wright, and they're rejoicing in Hallelujah Land.
Yeah, the hit is going to come from Robinson from the right side of the screen, right down on the ground. A great bounce up for the senior, Roderick Wright. And he rumbles, not ever looking back, too. That's the great thing about that run for Roderick Wright. A lot of guys would be wondering, who's gaining on me? Well, if you never look back, you'll never know. Head down and trucking.
I thought it was quite elegant.
A big ugly scoring at the state fair, you bet.
Yes, indeed.
A lot of bruises today, none worse than that one.
He had a hard time getting up.
He got no air. No air in that body right now.
He's draining it.
The celebration is quieted down for a moment after Roderick Wright's dramatic sprint to the end zone to make it a 45-12 ball game. Texas leading, and the horns will kick off to the Sooners, and it's become utterly dominating. Oh, we've got a head of neck shaping up there in this third round. And the kick is short, returned by Lindy Holmes. And Holmes almost spinning away and getting away. And we've got a scuffle going on back up the field, but they get there and separate it. And now you get your penalty flag, and it's going to go against Texas. Eric Foreman was involved in it, and one of the Sooners, and he threw an elbow just as the official arrived, and that'll cost him. Here's scores of the Big 12 now. Kansas State's gone out 12-3 over Kansas. Baylor and Iowa State are tied in the fourth quarter, and Texas Tech gets the early lead on Nebraska, while Missouri is bouncing back against the Cowboys, and the Aggies and Buffaloes will play tonight.
Go back to the penalty. Number 21 is Eric Foreman fighting against number 21, Jacob Gutierrez. Gutierrez with the takedown there. Foreman didn't like the way he was laying on top of him, and you wouldn't either. Now when they get up, Foreman took a jab at Gutierrez and got the flag.
This is Dante Hickson. Dante had a big play earlier in the ballgame for the Sooners, and he picks up about 5 yards on that carry at 7 minutes and 21 seconds to play in the game.
And if you're wondering about Adrian Peterson this afternoon, 10 yards rushing on 3 carries, and totally ineffective because of that bad right ankle.
Well, he'll be in a boot probably for a couple of weeks. Better off to get him well, I think, would think at this point. Hickson shakes off the first grasp and will get down across the 30, but still short of the first down. So they effectively are just running out the clock in the ball game to put it in the books as a complete game, because the issue is decided. 45-12, Texas, breaking Oklahoma's five-game win streak.
And you look down at Mac Brown on the sidelines, and you don't see that monkey anymore on his back, do you?
Nope. This is Hickson, but he's got a first down despite getting hammered by two horns as he reaches the 28.
But he did talk about this team making history. They said he made history last year when they went out and beat Michigan at the Rose Bowl. History earlier this year when they went to the Horseshoe in Columbus and beat the Buckeyes. And now snapping this five-game losing streak to their bitter rivals. More history.
Pretty good run. You put away Michigan, Ohio State, Oklahoma.
Yeah, of course, sir. Huh?
First down. All the Sooners, and we've got all kinds of movement along the front. We'll pass along our thanks to the sports information directors and their staffs, Kenny Mossman from Oklahoma and John Bianco from the University of Texas.
Number three of the offense, five-yard penalty. Still first down.
Of course, I never think about Texas or go to Texas that I don't have a chance to visit with Bill Little, who's been a long, long time friend. He's been there 38 years.
Wonderful host.
Yep.
Take a look at our game plan that we talked about before the game. Obviously, the Texas Longhorns have outrushed the Sooners, and they did get to young Rhett Bomar. 9 hits, 2 sacks, and 55 bruises.
Bomar's pass is right quicker, but there are 3 Longhorns on the top. 3 of them.
Bomar's pass.
This defense is impressive.
And the impressive thing is you see they're all still out there. All the starters are still out there on the field.
Second down and 9. Oh, sailed. I may have been tipped at the line of scrimmage. May have been tipped. We're getting down into the middle of the season in a lot of the conferences around the country where games are taking on a lot of meaning. There's one going out on the West Coast today. Tonight with California and UCLA both undefeated. And tonight you've got Ohio State at Penn State in the Big Ten, big ball game. This is Gutierrez. And Jacob will have a first down for Oklahoma. Gutierrez put it on the 17 after that run. I think that the Colorado Bowl game tonight will be a pretty good one, too.
Yeah, I think so. You know, also in the Pac-10, Arizona State and Oregon are playing after getting out ahead of USC, both failing to beat the top team in the country the last 2 weeks.
I wonder if they'll just call off the fourth quarter. Hickson, Dante Hickson. Slants at the right side and picks up something. Oklahoma with Kansas coming in would figure they might be able to rest Adrian Peterson. Get a win there without having to use it. That would help his circumstances considerably. On the other hand, Texas going home will have Colorado, and I got a hunch of Buffalo's keep kind of busy. Remember, we were down there a few years ago, and Rashan Salam of Colorado had the game of his life, and it was national telecast. He went on to win the Heisman Trophy as a result of that, but he played much of the second half with a concussion and didn't remember it. This is Kimon Jones, and he met a lot of folks from Texas as he got to the line of scrimmage, but that's all right. He is a true Oklahoman from Tulsa.
Yeah, I'm sure that Stoops will look back on this game, and depending on how badly hurt Adrian Peterson continues to be with that right ankle, wish he didn't play him at all. He did not practice much at all with the offense this week. And the pregame warm-ups just came out and trotted around a little bit. Didn't look good at all.
Look out. Boy, he twisted himself and avoided Bobino just enough to keep from getting crushed. The loss is all the way back to the 24-yard line.
And we've seen the Sooners twice this year, once against UCLA, and Bomar took some unbelievable hits in that game. And he's taken way, way too many in this game. Tough kid.
Texas' largest margin of victory historically is 33 points. That's what the margin is right now. Back in 1941, it was 40-7. Right now, it's 45-12. And here comes a field goal try by Garrett Hartlett. And Hartlett's kick, a lot of air under it, but he missed it.
Yeah, bad snap. Tough for Freebie to get the ball down. In good place for Hartley.
Now 2:22 to go in the ball game. This has been a tough day for Bob Stoops. He had high hopes, hoping that his young people were ready to play a big ball game, but obviously they're not quite there yet. But his brother Mike, who's the head coach at Arizona, is facing off USC tonight. The Chevy players of the game today: Zach Latimer, 11 tackles for Oklahoma. And Vince Young, obviously, for Texas. A load of numbers for him, 14 out of 27, 241 yards and 3 touchdowns. He ran for 45. And Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to the general scholarship fund of each of these universities. Ran into Don Elliott today, who was one of the people at Chevrolet who helped develop this Chevrolet scholarship program many, many years ago. So. And Minnesota has just defeated Michigan 23-20. So it's been a hard year for the Wolverines. They had a ton of injuries early on, and Lord Carr's team is having a rough go. And we're down inside a minute to go now. So it's been fun being back for the 100th game of the old Cotton Bowl series, the Red River Rivalry, they call it, between Oklahoma and Texas. And this round goes to Texas.
Yeah, and thanks for letting me be your caddy, Keith. I think it's quite appropriate that you were here to call this one.
Well, it was fun for you to have a chance to see it, because this is one of those things that you should see.
Absolutely.
Great one to remember. And now that should be it as we go inside 15 seconds to play. Todd Harris is in for two. Mac Brown right now, so we can get a closing comment from him after a very solid performance by his number two ranked Texas Longhorns. Here's Todd.
Coach, congratulations. Talk about getting a monkey off your back. You break the streak.
Well, Todd, the greatest thing about this, it's good for our kids. We're 5-0. Now we got to go back and play Colorado next week.
What was the difference this week between years past?
We had a better team this year coming in, had an older quarterback. Vince was experienced, and we've got a really good football team if we'll keep improving.
We had a chance.